Hello, my dear children. I hope all of you are fine and taking precautions to protect yourself against COVID-19. So today, let us start with the part 2 of science. Lesson number 1, adaptation in plants, class 4th. Okay. So before we start part 2, I want you people to take just few seconds and recollect that what we have learned in the part 1. Yes, in the part 1, we have learned about the adaptation in plants. Adaptation is nothing but the different methods which the plants are adopting to survive, okay? Like the methods of how to disperse the seeds, or how to take sunlight, how to store water, how to store food, etc. And even we have learned that the plants are being classified into two types. One is the aquatic and water plant, and the second one is terrestrial and land plant. So in the part 1, we have discussed about the aquatic and water plants. Aquatic and water plants are of three types. Which one? Their first one was a free floating plant, second one was fixed floating plant, and third one was underwater plant. So free floating plant means what? The plants which will just flow on the water. No part will lie under the water. So it will just float on the water. And fixed floating plant means what? The plants which is lying on the water also, as well as it is fixed, the roots are fixed underground, underwater. And underwater plants is nothing but the total overall plant will be under the water. It nothing part of the plant will be on the surface of the water. Total part will be on under water. So now today, in the part 2, we will learn about terrestrial or land plants. So as the name itself says, terrestrial or land plants means what? The plants which will grow on the land. This is our land where we can move. Okay. So this now in the terrestrial and land plant, it will explain us that what type of plants are there which will grow on the land. Let us begin. Everyone, take out page number 99. This one, terrestrial or land plants. Let us begin. All plants growing on land are called terrestrial plants. Majority of plants grow on land. Largest living being on earth is also a land plant. It is a giant sequoia tree found in California, USA. It is 83 meters tall. The diameter of its trunk is 24 meters. It is also known as General Sherman. Land plants are of the following types. So, the plants which will grow on the land, as I said you before, the plants which will grow on the land are called as what? Terrestrial plants. So majority of the lands, like more than half of the plants, out of 180% of the plants will grow on the land. So one of the plant which is very big is the on the earth, the largest living being on the earth is also a land plant. So that land plant is called as what? Sequoia tree, which is found in California, USA. This tree is found in California, USA, and it is the largest plant on the land. The trunk is 24 meters. You can see over here how much 24 meters is. So the trunk of that plant is 24 meters, and again the leaves and something, that part is also different. So only the trunk is how much? 24 meters. So this much long it is, and it is also known as General Sherman. Land plants are of following types. So land plants are again divided into few types. What are those? Common land plants, sea coast plants, hill plants, desert plants, parasitic plants, insectivorous plant. So today we will learn about common land plant, sea coast plant, and hill plants. So as aquatic plants were divided into three types, similarly these land plants are also divided into few types. First one is what? Common land plant. Plains support a large variety of plants including trees. They can bear hot summer and cold winter conditions. Peepal, mango, banyan, shisham, etc. So what are plains? Plains are nothing but the land which is surrounded by the water. That is called as what? Plains. So these plains, wherever the land is there which is surrounded by the water, this helps the plants to grow nicely, or to grow like a variety of plants including the trees also. So these type of plants which is on a common land plant, or which will grow on the plains, they can bear even the hot season, summer season, as well as the winter season. there few plants are there which can grow only in the winter season, few plants are there which can grow only in the rainy season, and few plants are there which can grow in the summer season. But the plants or the trees which is surrounded by the plains or which is situated in the plainy area, it means that can bear both hot as well as the winter season. So example of that is a peepal tree, mango tree, banyan tree, sesame tree, etc. These are the few examples. So they as well, these are big trees. These trees have a large number of branches as well as developed root system. Sunflower, mustard, rye, wheat, rice, etc. are common small land plants. So the example, peepal, mango, banyan and sesame, these are the big trees. Okay, and sunflower, mustard, wheat and rice, etc. these are what? Small plants. These are considered as what? Small plants. So these plants have number of branches. Number of branches in the sense, now for example, if this tree, one of the, you can see if one of the tree is growing over here. Okay, so again this with the root system, they will have so many number of branches. Okay, and these branches again will help to grow new tree. Understood? Whether it is a big tree or whether it is a small tree. So this will help to grow again a new tree. This is what common land plants. So these are the common plants which can you can grow wherever the land is there, but that land must have enough water facilities. So these trees you can easily grow over there. Next is what? Sea coast plant. So that first one was land plant which can grow wherever the you have land with the water facilities. So you can grow that type of plants. But now this plant is what? Sea coast plant. So this plants you can grow only in the sea area, wherever the sea are there, towards the sea. Jape sea ka pani hai. Towards that side at the coastline you can grow this crops. So which are those crops? Let us see. Coconut, palm and pepper grow in hot and damp places like sea coast. Teak, rubber and sugarcane are also such plants. So examples of that is what? Coconut, palm and pepper. They grow, they need what? Hot in the sense summer season. So these trees can grow in the summer season and damp places. Damp means what? Wet places. So wherever the wet place is there and during the hot season, these plants can grow. And teak, rubber and sugarcane are also such plants. So these are some few examples are what? Tea, rubber and sugarcane. Another example is what? Mangrove trees grow in a swamp. Mangrove plants like a rhizophora grow in swamps. The soil in swamp is clayey. It does not have air. So the roots cannot breathe and they grow above the ground. So what are the examples? Mangrove tree example is what? Rhizophora plant. This is a plant which can grow in the swamp area. Swamp area means what? Soft, wet land. Just little bit of wet land and this mangrove trees can grow over there. So the soil in the swamp is clay. Clay means what? Chikna. So jo uska soil hai, wo little bit like clay type. Okay, so you have noticed clay, it's like you know, sticky type. So the soil is sticky and it does not have any air. So the roots cannot breathe and they grow above the ground. So it means like sea coast, some of the coconut, palm and pepper, they grow in the totally wet area where the wet it is there, where little bit of water is there, totally wet. Hamesha pani present hota hai unke roots mein. But mangrove trees like rhizophora, they can grow only in a soft wet, thoda sa hi gille plant, gille zameen par wo grow kar sakta hai. So and the soil is what? Soil is clay. And the roots or this plant does not contain air. So that's why jo unke branches hai wo ground ke above grow karte hai. It is above the ground. Next is what? Hill plants. So it does not mean ki jo coconut hai, that is a sea coast plant. It means this plant can grow on the land. No, these are land plants only. But few land plants which can easily grow on the land, but few plants are there who needs sea. Jo sea ke, that all that will also grow on the land, but it needs what? It needs sea water. And next is what? Hill plants, which will grow on the hillsides. So let us start. Tea plants are grown on hill slopes because they need plenty of rains. They do not bear standing water near their roots. In India, tea plants are grown in hilly regions like Assam and Darjeeling. So these tea plants, they can grow on the hill slopes, totally on the hill, okay, on the above. And they need plenty of rains. So these plants, these trees are there, which depends on what? Which depends on rain. They need what? Rain. So they can easily grow on rains. And they cannot bear standing water near their roots. Like how the sea coast ka jo plants rehte hai, suppose this is the sea coast plant, it is compulsory for them ki unke roots pe pani rehna. But the hill plants jo hills pe rehte hai, agar unke roots kane pani hai, so they cannot bear at all. Just only thing they need what? They need rain. So if the water is standing on the roots, they cannot bear it. Example of this hill plants are what? Tea plants. And where they would grow? They grow Assam and Darjeeling regions. Which hilly regions? They grow in the region, hilly regions of Assam and Darjeeling. Other common plants in hills are conifers or pines. They have needle-like leaves. They have cones instead of flowers. Seeds develop in these cones, so they can bear the cold and heavy rains of the hills. Cedar, fir and pine are such trees. So other hilly plants are what? Conifer and flower, pines. So how do uski leaves ka structure kya hai? Needle, have you ever seen needle? Swing. So the structure of their leaves is like a needle, a thin needle. So the structure is like a needle, and even they have a cone. Okay, instead all the plants will have a flower, but this hilly plants will have what? Cone. How the cone will look like? The cone will look like this. Okay, so they will have what? They will have cones instead of flowers, and seeds will develop through these cones. So suppose, for example, this is a needle like structure. Needle is the leaf. Instead of flower, they will have what? Cone. And the seeds will grow in this cone. This is the type of plant which will grow in the hilly region. So they can bear cold and heavy rains. As the hilly regions are cold regions, so they can bear cold as well as heavy rains. And example, some of the few examples which are given, that is cedar, fir and pine are the types of trees. Next. Spruce tree has straight trunk and hard branches. It is used as a Christmas tree. Trees of fruits like walnut and almond also grow on hills. So one example, this is a spruce tree. You can see the trees over here, different types of trees. So this spruce tree has what? A straight trunk. It also looks like a Christmas tree. This can also be used as a Christmas tree. So this spruce tree has a straight and a hard trunk. And trees of fruits, the trees which will grow, give fruits like walnuts and almonds, badam. So ye bhi jo badam aapko milta hai, almonds you will get, that plants will also grow on the hills. So these are the few plants which will grow on the hills. Again, let us just recollect it, like common land plants which can grow on the land, but they need water, enough water so that they can grow. And another is what? The sea coast plant, which these plants will grow where the sea are there, towards the sea coast side. And to this plant, it is compulsory that they should have adequate water towards the roots. Another one is the hill plants. These hill plants depends on the rain, and they can easily grow on cold rainy season. So if the plant, if this hill plants have water towards their roots, they cannot bear it. They just depend on the cold as well as the rainy season. Few examples were given: almond tree and walnut, spruce tree, cedar, fir, pine, and even the tea plant. These are the plants which will grow on hilly areas, or you can call it as hilly plants. So again, in the part 3, we will discuss about the desert plant, parasitic plant and insectivorous plant. Till then, what we have discussed in the part 1 and part 2, just understand it and go through the lesson, read the lesson so that you can improve your reading skills also. Collect the hard words, which are the hard words are there, or new words for you. Underline that new words also. Okay, we'll meet again with the next session in part 3, where we will discuss about desert plant, parasitic plant and insectivorous plants. So these 3 bits I'm going to take in the next session. Till then, go through part 1 and part 2. Okay, so we'll meet in the next class. Till then, goodbye. Take care.